NCAA tournament qualifiers the last 3 years. The Loyola Ramblers come in 11-3 on the season. They've won 8 of their last 9. The Bradley Braves are 9-5 overall, and they're looking to reach that 10-win plateau. They are 3-2 after a 2-week shutdown. Alongside the former coach, Kevin Lehman, I am Brad Wells. Welcome to Peoria, Illinois. Coach, today we've got two teams that, once again, are going to be in the hunt for this Missouri Valley Conference regular season title.
You've got two teams that know their culture, they know their identity. And this is a Loyola team that's won 2 of the last 3 regular season titles, and a Bradley team that's won the last 2 postseason tournaments at Arch Madness. Can Bradley bounce back from that loss to Illinois State? And Loyola, since the lineup change, they've won their last 3 games by an average of 31 points. Can they do it against one of the best defenses in the country, the Bradley Braves?
They're playing at an elite level, and as we look at 2 premier teams, we take a look at a couple premier players. Let's begin with the Loyola Ramblers. Kevin, Cameron Krewick, he can score it. He can rebound it, and he can dish it with the best of them. And when I say the best of them, I mean the best of them.
He's an exclusive club. You've got 1,500 points, over 800 rebounds, over 300 assists for Cameron Krewick. He's in a club with guys named Oscar, Larry, Hersey, guys you want to say their last name. Krewick, on his resume, he's got a Final Four. He's got a triple-double. This guy can score in lots of ways, and the offense runs through Krewick, the best passing center in the country.
Kevin, Elijah Childs, Valley MVP as a sophomore. Now he's in his senior season.
Well, what this guy does, he makes tough, contested twos. Elijah Childs, he's also moving up the ranks in Bradley history. He's 4th in blocks, 9th all-time in rebounds. He's coming off his third double-double against Illinois State. And his 14 games, Brad, all 14 double figures for Elijah Childs.
Championship aspirations. This is a sweet matchup coming from Peoria, Illinois. Loyola and Bradley.
It was never about the gold. It was always about the goals. I didn't reach them just by training my body, but my mind as well. So close your eyes. Visualize all the ways you could break through. Then, imagine everything that could go wrong. A false start, a bad turn, broken goggles. Now picture yourself staying calm and overcoming every obstacle. Open your eyes. Train what's under the armor.
Ballin', but on a budget. The new $1 Your Way menu at Burger King will help you stack that bread, spend less bacon. So try a flame-grilled bacon cheeseburger, chicken junior, fries, or a drink for just $1 each. So save that bacon and get it on your burger instead, because getting more for your buck at BK just hits different. The new $1 Your Way menu, now at Burger King. Your way, way better.
The emerging stars in the NBA.
It's NBA on ESPN time. Lakers Celtics on ABC.
Hi, Peyton.
Mr. President.
I understand you want to forward fast to it.
It's target practice.
Here we go. Yes! To infinity and beyond. It's a UFM, an unidentified flying Manning.
Bush. Grubhub Perks give you deals on the food you love. The kind of deals that make you boogie. Get the food you love with Perks from Grubhub.
The Missouri Valley Game of the Week is brought to you by State Farm. When you want the real deal, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. By Zervita. By Prairie Farms, locally owned, locally produced since 1938. And by Mercy, your life is our life's work. Welcome inside Carver Arena, where the Bradley Braves are getting set to host the Loyola Ramblers. in a matchup that could have big-time seeding implications for the top three seeds at this year's Valley Tournament. Now let's take a look at today's starting lineups, a presentation of Prairie Farms, dedicated farmers, happy cows, real milk. For the visiting Loyola Ramblers, Lucas Williamson on the all-defensive team a season ago. For the Ramblers, you have Norris Clemens Kretwig, a first-team All-Valley performer a season ago, and Ahir Ugwak. And for the Bradley Braves, you have Terry Nolan Jr., Sean East II, Elijah Childs, Ville Tavanainen, and Rink Mast, who has done an excellent job in that starting lineup. And let's take a look at our keys to the game, made possible by Grinnell Mutual. Trust in tomorrow. Talk to a Grinnell Mutual agent today. Kevin, let's start with the Ramblers.
Well, if you're the Ramblers, you have to match the physicality of Bradley. We're talking about on the ball, they're going to climb in your space. And on the backboard, you have to battle that big front line. You've got to win the small battles. We're talking about 50-50 balls, so important on the road. Transition baskets. And you look at the Bradley Braves. This is going to be a grinded out game. It always is, Bradley, when these two meet. Long possessions, both offensively, defensively, and bench production. We've got a Bradley team with Jashawn Henry out. There's 12 points a game. Ari Boya, their shot blockers out. McAdoo's out, 4 points a game. Can they get enough production off their bench from their freshmen to compete with this Loyola team?
Bradley looking for a bounce back game after a loss to the Illinois State Redbirds earlier this week. The Ramblers, another convincing win when they beat Valparaiso earlier this week after handling Northern Iowa at home last weekend. Childs unable to get the first attempt for Bradley to go, and Norris sets up the Ramblers offensively. Out to Clemens, 3-point shot. Loyola starts it hot.
That's the lineup change Porter Mosier made 3 games ago. He put Clemens in the lineup. He's got a hop in his step. Tate off the bench. Tate Hall off the bench has been outstanding.
This is East along the baseline. Ville Tavanainen, one of the top shooters for Bradley. If he has a good game, Bradley has a great shot at winning. Childs, the deep two, challenged by Kretwig, and it'll be Rambler basketball. Loyola head coach Porter Mosier in his 10th season, 17th career season. 173 wins at Loyola has him amongst the top three in Rambler head coaches.
Final four appearance, 2 of the last 3 regular season championships for Porter Mosier.
And Cameron Kretwig gets the bucket to go inside. The wraparound as the Ramblers 2 for 2 offensively. East gets bumped by Norris for the first foul of the game. Bradley Braves head coach Brian Wardle in his 6th season with the Braves, 11th overall. See, 90 and 91 as Braves head coach. Valley Tournament wins the last 2 seasons.
31-year drought for the Braves before Brian Wardle takes them to that Arch Madness Championship in 2019. Done an outstanding job here rebuilding this program.
His Childs looked like he slipped underneath, able to collect himself and get the finish to put Bradley on the board.
We mentioned Elijah Childs makes tough contested twos. That one right over the top of Kretwig.
Kretwig guarded by Rink Mast. Mast, 6'9", big man, gets whistled for the foul, the push on the back.
Well, thus far, both teams have not sent a second defender. Bradley has not sent a second defender at Kretwig. It's been one-on-one. At the other end, it's been Childs going one-on-one against Kretwig. Both coaches talked about changing up how they defend the most explosive player on each team. Kretwig for Loyola and Childs for the Braves.
Kretwig is going to back him down. Tavanainen sneaking down for that double team. First miss of the day, but an offensive rebound. Ugwat grabbed the board of Clemens' 3-point attempt.
We talk a lot about Kretwig and Williamson and Norris, but this guy is an unsung hero. Ahir Ugwak. big time offensive rebound. He has killed it in league play, 16 and 19 from the field in league play.
It's called for an illegal screen here. As Bradley gets it back, here Uguac, fifth year senior, a transfer from New Mexico back in 2017.
He's out of the same program that Ben Cricky from Valpo's out of Edmonton, Alberta, Edmonton. Canadian, a lot of Canadians we see in the U.S. playing ball.
East tries to finish, doesn't get the roll. Here comes Norris. Two of the top defensive teams, not just in the Missouri Valley Conference, but in the country, Kevin. And this is likely going to slow down the pace of the game today as both teams really play physical. They get up and defend you.
You've got to be able to execute deep in the shot clock. Both coaches talk about trying to get some easy baskets in transition because going against half-court defense is so difficult. And those type of hoops are big right there. Crowley gets one off the glass. Offensive rebound.
Offensive putback. Might be the easiest two we'll see here today. There's a pass that over the head of East and out of bounds. And here's that defense that we're talking about. The far right column, it's where these teams rank in the NCAA. Loyola second best in scoring defense. Bradley ranking for scoring defense, field goal defense, and blocks per game.
Yeah, they've been outstanding, both these squads. We talked about their identity and their culture. It starts at the defensive end. Their scouting reports and personnel study is outstanding.
Both allowing less than 63 points per game. Reasons like that. There's the block factor. Rink Mast gets the block on Krutwig. It's going to stay with the Ramblers.
Well, Mast is the redshirt freshman out of the Netherlands. Big and strong. He's in the lineup, says Ari Boya, has the injured foot. Watch him body up the big man. Krutwig tries to get a little bit on that left elbow chicken wing. Mast holds his ground, gets the block. Norris, reverse layup, gets it to go.
Braden Norris, the sophomore, with a big bucket there for Loyola. Ramblers up seven.
And Porter Mosier loves what Brandon Morris brings to this team. Pitbull, he calls him. Norris, the pitbull.
Lucas Williamson comes up with the steal on the Missouri Valley Conference all-defensive team a season ago. Whistle. As there's a foul on Nolan away from the ball.
You're going to see a lot of what we call high middle of the court ball screens between Brandon Norris and Cameron Krutwig. Norris is so adept at using his vision and speed coming off that high screen.
There's Nolan with the steal and then a foul on Clemens. And both teams with three fouls early in this first half.
Oh, this is a point in the game where if Porter Mosier had a jacket, it would have came off, Brad. You cannot turn the ball over on an OB play for the Ramblers.
And he was asked about the coach's sideline wardrobe and how it's just with dealing with the COVID protocols, it's gotten rid of the suit and tie. And I think a lot of head coaches are pretty comfortable with the golf shirt. And
they are. Those announcers, we're still wearing ties. We got to get with the program here, Brad. We got to go golf shirt. Golf polo.
Here's Clemens gets it back. Knocks in the three.
Wow, that's big time for Clemens. He's knocked in two of them now. He only had eight on the season, but we're seeing a healthy Keith Clemens fought knee injury most of the early part of this season.
Mast for three. Rebounded by Williamson. So ahead to Uguac. He wants to attack. Blocking foul called on Childs. That's the first on Elijah Childs. Well, the Loyola Ramblers, 5 of 7 shooting so far. They're 2 for 3 from outside. Clemens uses Krutwig. It's a 10-point lead.
It's NBA on ESPN time. Lakers Celtics on ABC.
One app, one tap, that's that. One swipe, one slice, and get back. Always on the pulse, yo, we got it going on. Listen up and take cover, here comes a wolf bomb. No one else goes deeper, that's a fact. One slide, one tap, it's the ESPN app.
Hi, Peyton.
Mr. President.
I understand you want to forward fast to it.
It's target practice.
Here we go. Yes! To infinity and beyond. It's a UFM, an unidentified flying Manning.
The emerging stars in the NBA.
It's NBA on ESPN time. Lakers Celtics on ABC.
Hey, Peyton, what brings you to the Coliseum?
I'm here for Super Bowl I. The jetpacks. Are those still around?
Hi, Peyton.
Mr. President.
I understand you want to forward pass to it.
You can't shoot with that.
Omaha. That's it.
There yes! it is!
It's a quarter mile long.
And I don't really want to run any more than I have to.
To infinity and beyond. It's a UFM, an unidentified flying Manning.
Hulu show my team hit a game winner. Switch. I seen it walk off for a series clincher. Hulu has live sports. Hulu.
Damn, that was dope. But it's Hulu doesn't just have live sports.
Hulu doesn't just have live sports.
You also have to say 65 live channels. Plus Hulu's entire streaming library.
I don't know, man. We can make that work, right? Hulu doesn't just have live sports. It's a lifestyle.
12-2, Loyola has opened up a 10-point lead on the road. They have done it with some hot shooting as the Ramblers 2-for-3 from the outside. Clemens shooting them all, but Kevin, their improvement in three-point shooting has been fantastic.
8.4 this year. They made under 6 a season ago. And Porter Moser even told us last year, we know we're a good three-point shooting team. This year he wants to get up at least 21 attempts per game, but look at their numbers. And we even talked about Keith Clemens is not on this list. He's knocked in 2 already, but Welch has been outstanding. Uguak at 42%. Williamson has increased almost 10 percentage points over last season. This is a dangerous Loyola Rambler team from the perimeter.
Now Williamson, 33% last year, 41% this season. And the Missouri Valley Conference as a whole, Kevin, they have 5 teams in the top 50 in the NCAA in three-point field goal percentage. Loyola, 18 in the country.
Yeah, and if you watch Bradley play, they are one of the tops in the country defending the two-point shot, but they are not that highly ranked in defending the three. So look for the Ramblers to try to knock down the three ball to loosen up that Bradley defense. They've been successful early in this game.
Tom Welch and Tate Hall in the game for the Loyola Ramblers, as is Marquise Kennedy. And Darius Hanna on the court for Bradley.
Now, Hanna, an outstanding looking freshman for Bradley. That last trip, Terry Nolan, he's their big time bucket getter. Lost the handle. Turnover for the Braves.
Kennedy looking to drive, drug his pivot foot. That's a turnover. And Porter's not happy.
No, this is a Loyola team that prides itself in controlling the basketball. We've had 3 unforced turnovers this far for Loyola Ramblers. That's very uncharacteristic of this team.
And that's probably, Kevin, would you say the biggest thing with facing a physical team is it maybe forces you into more of those uncharacteristic turnovers?
Well, Bradley is outstanding at digging at the ball in the drives, but we've had an illegal screen for a turnover. We had a turnover on an OB play.
East misses the shot, rebounded by Uguak.
Well, Bradley just not getting good looks. Childs had a couple early and misfired.
Clemens wants to drive the lane, has it knocked away from behind. Childs checking back in, and Daniel Kingsby checking in as well. Look at this Rambler defense.
Well, they really dig at the ball. They recover with what we call high hands that contest the shot. You drive the gaps. You got to be careful because help side defenders are always engaged for the Ramblers.
Clements comes out to get it from Welch. Screen action on the right side. And Hannah nearly came up with a steal. It's going to stay with Loyola. 9 on the shot clock here.
You got Welch in the game for Krutwig, and they'll use him more in that pick and pop play, the five-man Welch. Outstanding three-point shooter.
Bugwak fires the three. That's off the mark. And here comes Bradley. They need a basket. Haven't scored for 4 minutes. Childs goes to work against Ugwak. He gets deep on Ugwak. The shot doesn't go. And Childs saves it from going out of bounds, but now the Ramblers have numbers.
That's two for Childs that just skipped off the rim.
Tate Hall in the lane, lays it in. And Tate Hall has been a big pick-me-up since he's been pulled out of the starting lineup, as he's the Missouri Valley Conference Player of the Week this past week.
It took all the pressure off Tate Hall. He has been outstanding coming off the bench for the Ramblers.
Foul on Welch inside. Let's take another look at that.
Left-hander gets it on the deck. Splits the defenders, all able to score at the rim. Since he's coming off the bench, he's been shooting 64%. 18 of 28 coming to this game. Porter Mosier pulled all these guys in and talked about the lineup change and told Tate Hall, you're going to be like Andre Jackson was on our Final Four team. Sixth man of the year. Took the pressure off Hall. He has been sensational since that lineup change.
Big basket here after entering the game, immediately having an impact. Norris and Williamson re-enter for Loyola. Antonio Thomas into the game, and Nolan. The top of your screen as Childs fires another free throw. Nolan, the offensive rebound, then lost it. Somebody tipped it right out of his hands, and he couldn't regather it. Loyola gets it back.
Well, one of the keys we talked about, especially for Loyola, is you got to win those small battles, the turnover battle, the 50-50 balls. Ramblers come up with another.
Bradley still empty on the offensive end for a five-minute stretch now. Here's Kennedy. Blows by Hannah and finishes with authority. Timeout, Bradley.
Marquise Kennedy. He gets from point A to point B as fast as anyone in the league. Puts the defender on skates. Punches it through. Boy, the freshman got put on a poster.
It's Kennedy at 6'1". Hannah at 6'8", tried to come from behind, but so quick to the rim.
On the all-bench team last year, Marquise Kennedy gives the Rams some real pop off the bench.
On the Missouri Valley Conference all-freshman team. Sixth man, preseason third team all-Missouri Valley Conference. 8 points, 5 rebounds in the game against Valparaiso. Has got that potential to be one of those guys. He's one of the many Ramblers that score 6 or more, because it's not just one or two guys.
Well, their bench is so strong. If you're going to win a Valley title, you got to be up some pop and some points off the bench. Marquise Kennedy gives that to Loyola. There's a double now on Childs.
Childs working against Hall. Hall got some help. Now Kingsby gets stripped.
Hands digging at it inside for the Ramblers.
Kennedy draws contact on Nolan. And we'll have 2 free throws coming here for Marquise Kennedy, a sophomore out of Chicago, Illinois.
Both of these squads want to run and try to beat the other team down in transition offense. It's tough to go against what we call loaded defenses in this league because the scouting is so well done. Easy to get baskets in transition. That's why turnovers are always huge in this type of game. But Ramblers are to a huge lead here early in this game.
You saw Terry Nolan Jr. heading to the bench. It's his second personal foul. Here's Kingsby on the drive. Pass out for Mass, tipped out of bounds.
by Hall.
Brad, this is the point where Bradley really misses Deshaun Henry, because you could play him at that three spot, the four spot. He's powerful. He's highly efficient player. Gets the free throw line, can make threes, can score inside. He creates offense for Bradley, but he is out with concussion protocol as he had a concussion Tuesday in a non-contact shooting drill for the Braves.
And just a running drill, collided with a teammate. And not ready to go. And you add that on top of Ari Boya, the seven-footer who's out with a foot injury, and Kevin McAdoo, who's on a leave from the team for family reasons. And the Ramblers in control here in this first half.
When you choose Bradley, T-Mobile is upgrading its network at a record pace. We were the first to bring 5G nationwide. And now that Sprint is a part of T-Mobile, we're turning up the speed, upgrading over 1,000 towers a month with ultra-capacity 5G to bring speeds as fast as Wi-Fi to cities and towns across America. And we're adding more every week. Coverage and speed. Who says you can't have it all?
Ball in, but on a budget. The new $1 Your Way menu at Burger King will help you stack that bread, spend less bacon. So try a flame-grilled bacon cheeseburger, chicken junior, fries, or a drink for just a dollar each. So save that bacon and get it on your burger instead, because getting more for your buck at BK just hits different. The new $1 Your Way menu, now at Burger King. Your way, way better.
Ah, a package. You know what this human ordered? A backache. Consider pain delivered. Pain says you can't. Advil says you can.
The emerging stars in the NBA.
It's NBA on ESPN time. Lakers Celtics on ABC.
This is the NBA's marquee matchup. Two franchises littered with Hall of Fame players. Two most successful franchises in NBA history. She's unstoppable. The emerging stars in the NBA.
It's Saturday prime time. It's NBA on ESPN time. Lakers Celtics, Saturday on ABC.
18-2, Loyola opening up a big first half lead in this big Missouri Valley Conference matchup. And let's take a look now at our Missouri Valley Conference standings. They are a presentation of Zervita, the Drake Bulldogs at the top of the list, about to be done with their 22 days off. They got a game scheduled for Tuesday finally. Loyola at number two and these Bradley Braves at number four.
Yeah, big games coming up as Drake goes to Missouri State. Those two, three teams at the top, Bulldogs, the Ramblers, and the Bears. And Bradley's trying to hang in there, but they look like they're playing with a hangover for that loss at Illinois State on Wednesday.
Loyola at Missouri State after this series against Bradley in the Missouri Valley Conference. Going to a back-to-back series schedule. So these two teams will play a rematch tomorrow evening as Williamson gets the putback, and Bradley has not looked sharp this afternoon yet, Kevin.
Coach, really, they give you second chance attempts. We've seen that twice now. Crutler with a putback, and there, Lucas Williamson. This is a Bradley team that is out of sync. They need to get a bucket. They need a little lifter.
There's Childs up to Tavanainen. Guarded tightly by Williamson. Childs comes up with the loose ball. Shot does not fall, and Krutwig there secures the rebound.
Well, you see some frustration on Childs' face. What a great transition hoop there by Tate Hall, coast to coast.
Another timeout taken by Bradley as Coach Wardle is going deep to his bench as Tate Hall just blew right by the entire Braves team.
Well, you don't see this happen to Brad. They're not getting back. They don't get the ball stopped. Hall goes all the way to the rim. We've talked about Tate Hall since he's come off the bench. He has been outstanding. This has been his fourth game as the sixth man. And as Porter Moser says, I have seven starters. We argue with him that he had eight. Tom Welch should be a starter. He said Crutwood would not allow that.
So maybe he's got eight starters, one that has to start every single game. Well, Bradley's going to their bench. Jason Kent, the freshman, is checking in. Connor Linke, a freshman, checking in, as well as Thomas Hall, a freshman. There's a look at Loyola's offense, as it just has been so solid, Kevin, the last 5 years.
It's very efficient, and a lot of it is the Rick Majerus factor on Porter Mosier. They get the shots they want. They run offense. Excellent. They can go deep in the shot clock, and they've got the big man in the middle. Crutwig can make plays for everyone.
Not a single starter on the floor for Bradley. Here's Kingsby.
That would be Brian Worrell sending a message to his top five.
Kingsby draws the foul on Norris. And for Braden Norris, that's his second personal foul. And he'll head to the bench as Clemens checks in.
Well, that ball goes to the net, but the foul's before the shot. So still Bradley digging the wells, but coming up dry.
Kingsby pull-up jumper, a sound we haven't heard since the 18-minute mark for Bradley.
Kingsby, a guy who had 25 starts last year for Bradley. He's got starter's experience.
With 7 minutes, 44 seconds, the scoring drought for Bradley. See if that sparks him. Here's Krutwig inside. He's deep on Linke and drug his pivot foot.
We'll get a little bench excitement for the Braves. Linke, the freshman, defends the senior, Krutwig.
See the energy and the noise from the Bradley starters on the bench.
Oh, that's so important here with empty arenas. You got to have a live bench.
Jason Kent, the freshman, knocks it in.
All those freshmen are eager to play for the Braves. Kent, big upside for this young guy. Had a breakout game against Missouri where he had 11 points in 15 minutes of play.
Tate Hall, blocked by Hannah. Here comes Kingsby. Kingsby traveled with the basketball is the call.
Well, Kingsby, there's three defenders back for Loyola. He should have pulled up at the free throw line and let something develop, but force the action. But I like what I see out of this young group for Bradley. Braves, Brad, they've got some freshmen in there, active hands, a lot of energy, but they've got to be able to score at the other end.
You mentioned it's Coach Wardle sending a message, and you can tell at the top of your screen, message received, as you see everybody standing on that Bradley bench. Now here's Clemens with the finish as the Ramblers just continue to roll.
Well, Tate Hall has been exceptional coming off the bench, but the guy he put in the starting lineup, Keith Clemens, healthy, he adds a new dimension to this Loyola team. You're basically playing with two point guards with Norris and Clemens with this type of lineup. Norris on the bench, but Clemens running that offense.
This is Williamson with the steal.
Great hands, anticipation by Williamson. He deserves a three.
He's been shooting at a 41% clip this season. That one in and out. Loyola, though, is a team still shooting 62% from the floor. DeMarc for Linke, out of bounds, and Bradley's starters coming back into the game.
Well, we talk about the lineup change, and here's one of the examples. Not only Clemens with a cut, but a great pass by King Krutt. A pocket bounce pass, catches in stride, finishes off the window. This is a Loyola team that is hitting on all cylinders at the offensive end.
That's 8 points now for Clemens.
Krutwig sporting that new mustache he grew here. That's his COVID mustache. I told him to put a little wax on the end of it. And then he was warming up. I don't think he was buying that from me.
He likes that mustache. Porter still makes a case once in a while, asks him to shave it. This is Welch inside.
Welch has such soft hands and delivery there by Ugwak.
Opening conference series, Welch had a career-high 18 points against Indiana State. kind of proving that he's a legitimate option.
Well, he's first in the Valley in field goal percentage. Tom Welsh, number 10. That's your backup to Crutwig. This bench for Loyola has been outstanding, averaging 32 points a game. They've had two of the last couple games where their bench has scored 40 points for the Ramblers. Depth, dangerous.
Especially depth that shoots 69% from the floor. Tavanainen and an offensive rebound. Here's East, has it taken away by Ugwak. Ugwak and Williamson. Ugwak takes it. Williamson's put back, blocked by Mast. Here's East, slows it down to fire the three. Williamson, another rebound.
Well, not the shot you want in this situation. I'd like to see Sean East take that at the basket, draw some contact. Bradley's got to get the free throw line. Brad, they got to get there and see the ball go through the net. There's what he does.
Slip screen to Welch, the finish.
He has such a great feel. Tom Welch, quick feet. This guy was an all-state soccer player. Illinois Gatorade Player of the Year, Welch. He has outstanding feet and hands.
Childs gets stripped by Kennedy. Marquise Kennedy now fires the three. East on the rebound. His 22-point lead is the largest of this half for Loyola. East with a bucket.
Now that's what East does well. He uses that high screen. He's a mid-range jump shooter. Sean East, the transfer from UMass. Got to get him in around the what we call the logo in the lane. And East is highly effective as a scorer and a passer.
Feet inside, Ugwak. Open underneath the rim.
Kafus with the delivery. Great back screen. Hard cut, Ugwak. See his active hands by Loyola on ball defense. That's what East does. Get up to that point.
East gets another shot at it. Ugwak finally clears the rebound.
Two good looks by Bradley, but they come up empty.
The Braves 4 of 18 at 22% thus far.
Well, they struggled the second half against Illinois State on Wednesday.
Welch a deep three off the mark. And a timeout on the floor. Loyola up 22. As they're getting it from the outside and the inside.
Well, here's your eighth man. Slip screen, gets the basket, lays it in soft. You got Loyola trying to run away with this one.
It was never about the gold. It was always about the goals. I didn't reach him just by training my body, but my mind as well. So close your eyes. Visualize all the ways you could break through. Then, imagine everything that could go wrong. A false start, a bad turn, broken goggles. Now picture yourself staying calm and overcoming every obstacle. Open your eyes. Train what's under the armor.
Stars in the NBA.
It's NBA on ESPN time. Lakers Celtics on ABC.
One app, one tap, that's that. One swipe, one slide, sing it back. One app running with elite QBs. Russell got the cannon throwing clutch TDs. Lil' Cross is over, step behind the line. Ain't no need to watch the clock, cause you know it's dang time, yeah.
You know what?
One app with the 30 for 30s. Two finger push-ups, Bruce Lee showing no mercy. Fat Five got the crew on deck. Best believe Bo knows OG Dupree, yeah. One app lets you follow any team, any league, any player. You control the whole scene. Plug in, got the stories on scroll. Shut the dish and not the news like it's food for the soul, yeah. One app, Van Pelt with the facts. One big thing, dropping knowledge in your labs. Always on the pulse, yeah, we got it going on.
Listen up and take cover, here comes a Walsh bomb.
One app, college game day attire. Coach O on the sidelines, screaming, go Tigers. Throw down when Nina's got that knockout right. There's only one champ at the end of the fight.
She's the goat.
No one else goes deeper, that's a fact. One slide, one tap, it's the ESPN app.
It's a fact.
30-8, the Loyola Ramblers putting it on the Bradley Braves on the Braves' home floor. And two teams picked towards the top of the Missouri Valley Conference before the season started. Well, NBC student athletes are positively impacting the communities where they live by sharing views and fostering a climate for change for future Valley pioneers. To learn more about mobilizing voices for change, visit mvc-sports.com/onevalley. As the Loyola Ramblers getting 8 points from Keith Clemens, and then a number of Ramblers all with made baskets. Bradley still seemingly looking for answers here, Kevin.
I've tried different lineups. They got Terry Nolan out there. He is their bucket getter. He's been quiet in this game, along with a number of other Bradleys. They've got to run, execute some offense. You don't try to shoot yourself out of a slump. You've got to execute out of these slumps.
Tavanainen will fire the three and connect his first shot of the game. And Kevin, Tavanainen is an X factor for Bradley this season.
Big key for the Braves. When he scores 10 a game, they win games. When he shoots it well from three, they win. That was his first good look. See if they can shake him loose for some other looks.
Tavanainen on the Valley all bench team a season ago. Here's Kennedy. Wild shot draws a foul as a blocking foul goes against the Braves and goes against Mast.
Really good ball movement on that offensive possession by Loyola. He went side to side, then attacked down the middle by Kennedy. Kennedy, explosive first step. He is so difficult to stay between him and the basket, Marquise Kennedy. The sophomore out of Brother Rice. Outstanding free throw shooter.
Marquise Kennedy, 8 points, 5 rebounds against Valpo at 10 points and 7 points in the two games against UNI last weekend. Third team preseason All-Valley selection.
I really like his game. He's got a little shimmy and shake. You know, he's one of the guys that Porter Mosier lets go one-on-one. He's got some space. Explosive first step. Difficult to stay in front of Marquise Kennedy. Now Braves got to get some execution. Need some movement.
6 points for Kennedy now. Here's Tavanainen, gets the lay in. 5 quick points for Vile.
Well, Brian Warren let those starters take a look at the freshman play. Now he brought him back in. A little more hop in the step from the Braves.
Kevin, those freshmen played well when they were out there. Here's Welch fires the three. Off the mark, long rebound to Nolan.
At the Braves, you got 4:30 left. You want to dig into this lead. Try to get down to it's a manageable number by halftime.
Top of nine and heat check. That one just off the rim.
I didn't like that shot. Contested three, had not moved the defense. So much better if they moved the Loyola defense from side to side before you attack.
You said execute out of a slump, right? Not shoot out of a
slump.
They
really do. You've got to get some execution and move your defenders around.
I'm listening. Krutwig gets fouled. Remind you to stay tuned for our halftime report, a presentation of State Farm Insurance. When you want the real deal, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. A Tate Hall feature. Take a look at first half stats and highlights coming up here.
This Tate Hall story is one of the great ones here in the Valley. Accepts that role coming off the bench, and what it does, ignited this offense for Loyola. After that, you know, they Northern Iowa, big win there, went into Evansville, had no problem, into Valparaiso, had no problem with Valpo. Lots because Tate Hall accepted that role to come off the bench, and it put in the starting lineup Keith Clemens, who's now a healthy Keith Clemens, gives him 2 point guards in that starting lineup with Norris and Clemens.
Hall started the first 11 games of the season. Came off the bench, 24 points against UNI. Was 8 of 12 shooting. In his first weekend coming off the bench.
This defense really has Bradley struggling to go. There is a great move by Ugwak. Step in there and take the charge.
Darius Hanna, the freshman, gets whistled for the offensive foul as Loyola's defense has been on lockdown mode here in this first half.
Grubhub Perks give you the kind of Panera deals that make you want to move. Get a free delivery perk on your first order from Panera. Only on Grub, what you love.
At Domino's, you can carry out 3-topping pizzas for just $7.99 each. And with Domino's Carside Delivery, you can conveniently stay in your car while you do it. Just pull up, check in online, and we'll quickly bring your food to you.
Thank you.
So you don't have to get out to get carry out. Like Denny here.
Hey, Hamlin. I like your PJs.
PJs? Stay in the driver's seat with Domino's Carside Delivery.
Welcome to Peloton Meditation. I'm taking a deep inhale.
I don't care. I gotta celebrate the moment, gotta own it before it blows away.
Look at that road in front of you. Let's go.
Blows away.
More gas to the fire.
Are y'all ready to have some fun? Left knee, left elbow. Reach for the sky.
This is Peloton. Get the app free for 2 months. New app trials only. Start today.
Now for Fabletics Men, our all-new line of shorts for 2021 are next level.
Next level tech.
Who added the voiceover?
They thought voiceover would elevate the spot.
What's about elevate the spot? Elevate what? I'm me. Do you not understand that? These are the new 2021 shorts from Fabletics Men. New tech, new look, new everything.
Two for $24. Sorry. Maybe I could just do the offer.
Thank you.
Get two pairs of shorts for $24 only at Fabletics.com.
Fabletics Men.
You're welcome.
I mean, really?
The Ramblers, a 3-touchdown lead here on the Bradley Braves as their defense has been just dynamite so far this first half. Well, when the NBC TV network crew travels to campus, it considers these properties home. These hotels consistently support the conference and its 10-member institutions. Please call and visit the websites of these properties when you're making plans to follow your favorite team away from home. Alongside Kevin Lehman, I am Brad Wells. We are in Peoria, Illinois, where the Bradley Braves coming in 3-2 in Missouri Valley Conference play. Had a 2-week shutdown over Christmas and New Year's. And Kevin, they were ahead by 1 on Illinois State at halftime on their midweek game and lost that game by 15 points. And now back-to-back halves where Bradley has not looked sharp defensively or offensively.
They've really struggled offensively. And Loyola's a team that gets into a rhythm on defense. You got to do things to take them out of that rhythm. They're so active with their hands, taking away gap dribbles. On-ball defense, outstanding by Loyola. Bradley can get zero penetration off the bounce.
Childs calling for it. Faces up against Uguac. Goes baseline, skips it baseline. Tavanainen for 3, off the mark. Here's East. The shot is no good. And Loyola clears the rebound once again. Krutwig inside working against Hanna and gets the bucket and an and one on the freshman.
Well, this is outstanding spacing in a transition off a missed shot. Watch the Ram as you're running. They'll fill the corners. Gets it up there, and there's the big man with his hand up, called for the basketball. Krutwig, and the delivery by Kennedy. Krutwig will get a chance for a 3-point play. That is outstanding spacing and timing in your offense.
Cameron Krutwig, the senior out of Algonquin, Illinois, gets the free throw to go.
Bradley is back on their heels. They can get nothing going at the offensive end. It's affecting their defense. Watch the active hands by the Ramblers.
This is Childs with the basketball. Connor Linke in the game. East, guarded tightly by Williamson. Such a good defender.
Yeah, Williamson, consider it an honor when he guards you. Sean East can get no penetration off Williamson.
Childs has to fire it to beat the shot clock. He gets it to go. And initial indication is that was a two. They're going to go to the monitor because that was close to being behind that three-point line. So they're going to go ahead and take a look at it right now.
You see the senior Childs calling his teammates together, some leadership. But shot clock at two. That left toe is on the line. The release is in time. That would be Child's second basket of this game as he's struggling to get open looks.
Bradley shooting just 30% from the floor. Everybody's struggling to get open looks for Bradley. There's another angle. Hard to tell from this view.
Yeah, I found that first one. I thought his left toe stepped on the line. When he did that up fake, Liza Childs. We had a good talk with him the other day. I said, what have you been doing in all your downtime? And he said, shoot hoops. I said, no, when you go back to the dorm. And he is a big fan of Netflix. Was it The Blacklist? Yeah, left toe clearly on the line.
He'll get the two. Jerry Pollard, Kip Kissinger, Jeff Mollum, the officials. That is Jerry and Jeff at the monitor.
Sometimes it just takes a basket like that, Brad, to get your offense going. Not out of your offense. Step through and beats the shot clock.
There you see the official indication from Jerry Pollard that it is a two.
Let's see if he puts a little more hop in the step. Of the Braves at the defensive end. They need to get some energy here. They got to get some loose balls. Get something in transition.
Uguak and Tate Hall both tightrope the out-of-bounds line, and Hall gets the finish inside.
One of the things Hall has done, he was shooting threes when he was struggling early this year, and now he's come off the bench. He's become a driver, getting all the way to the rim. We've seen him do it twice today. The left-hander slicing and dicing. Through that Bradley defense.
There's Childs inside. Gets a two over Krutwig.
Great catch by Childs. Kept the ball high. Finished.
There's Kennedy. Trying to shake East. Krutwig working against Linky. Dishes to Uguak, the two-hand stuff.
Well, the double came on the bounce. Krutwig is so good with the basketball. He delivers that soft bounce pass so Uguak can catch it in rhythm and take it right up to the rim. That's one of the things you don't talk about, the way that Krutwig passes so well off the bounce.
That's how he's got those 300-plus career assists to have him in that elite company of Oscar, Larry, and Hersey.
We talked about him as Uguak with the save. And now Hall is able to split the defenders and get it up off the rim. Hall had another great game off the bench for Loyola. And there's some more defense by the Ramblers.
Krutwig with a steal. Just takes it away. And a timeout taken by Porter Moser here with 45 seconds on the clock in this first half. Loyola up 24. This is their largest lead of the game. For Bradley, it's their largest deficit of the season. Kevin Loyola has been putting it on some teams here recently as they have been winning convincingly.
36-plus points in the same season. Loyola's got two games. And they were outstanding. I had them in that series against Northern Iowa that second night they came out. 88-46 over a Northern Iowa team that was picked to win this league before the injury to A.J. Green. And right there, number 24, Tate Hall, big reason. Coming off the bench, scoring big buckets for the Ramblers.
24 points for Tate Hall in that win. They followed it up with a win on the 20th, beating Valparaiso 75-39.
Bradley trying to get in the zone. They weren't sure that first pass through. Now they're all, they get themselves in like a 1-2-2 zone.
Uglock out to Kennedy. Kennedy slides through the defense. Uglock finishes again next to the rim.
Well, it's funny Uglock has done this. He was able to finish at the baskets. Order motion. He has worked diligently in the offseason to finish through traffic. That time, just a free lane. And before that, we saw that pass he got from Krutwig. Bounce off the deck.
This is East. It's over Krutwig and Williamson at the horn. Gets it to go. A basket for Bradley as the first half finishes. But 19 points for the Braves in the first 20 minutes. And Loyola has a 24-point lead over Bradley here at halftime. As we will come back with our State Farm halftime report. Stats, highlights, and more. But the Ramblers spreading out, a number of different players scoring, but they are scoring a lot and they are locking down the defense. It's the Ramblers rolling in Peoria.
You can't put a price on love, but if you did, it'd cost the exact same as a Reese's. Turns out love's kind of inexpensive. I'm sorry, Reese's.
One app, one tap, that's that. One swipe, one slide, sing it back. One app running with elite QBs. Russell got the cannon throwing clutch TDs. Lil' Cross is over, step behind the line. Ain't no need to watch the clock, cause you know it's dang time, yeah.
You know what?
One app with the 30 for 30s. Two finger push-ups, Bruce Lee showing no mercy. Fat Five got the crew on deck. Best believe Bo knows OG Dupre, yeah. One app lets you follow any team, any league, any player. You control the whole scene. Plugged in, got the stories on scroll. Shut the dish and not the news like it's food for the soul, yeah. One app, Van Pelt with the facts. One big thing, dropping knowledge in your labs. Always on the pulse, yeah, we got it going on.
Listen up and take cover, here comes a Woj bomb.
One app, college game day attire. Coach O on the sidelines, screaming, go Tigers. Throw down when Nina's got that knockout right. There's only one champ at the end of the fight.
She's the goat.
No one else goes deeper, that's a fact. One slide, one tap, it's the ESPN app.
It's a fact.
That go-go promise. Can't keep us gone. That new song. Yeah, right now. Super loud. Got the whole world watching.
I feel like I'm the good kind of spicy.
The Missouri Valley Game of the Week is brought to you by State Farm. When you want the real deal, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. By Zervita. By Prairie Farms. Locally owned, locally produced since 1938. And by Mercy. Your life is our life's work. Welcome back to our halftime report, a presentation of State Farm Insurance. When you want the real deal, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Let's look at our first half highlights made possible by Hotel St. Louis, where historic meets hip. And by the look of the score, the Loyola Ramblers leading so much. Yes, their offense, Kevin, was rolling.
They got 9 assists, but the big man, King Krutz, got 3 of those assists. Their offense has been outstanding here in the first half, highly efficient. As you can see, Welch get to the basket. Great ball movement side to side. Excellent passing. The back cut by Uglock and an easy 2 for the Ramblers.
Wow, Childs trying to get it going, but that Rambler defense game was just so tough.
They forced 9 turnovers. Childs struggled to get the ball in the basket. They doubled him. They single covered him. It's been stifling on defense for the Ramblers.
Loyola has forced Bradley into 11 turnovers. The result of it, the first 20 minutes, Loyola's highest scoring first half of the season, Bradley's lowest scoring first half of the season. Kevin, just how impressive was it what Loyola was doing?
We've seen it the last couple games since they made that lineup change. They've been so good at the offensive end. Bradley's been able to get nothing going at the defensive end. This is a Loyola team hitting at all cylinders, and we talk about that lineup change. Tate Hall coming off the bench, give him a big spark. Clemens in the starting lineup, but it all runs through the big man, Krutwig. He's been outstanding running this offense as they play through the center spot.
For the Bradley Braves, Wardle went to his bench, pulled in the freshman, everybody off the bench, went into the floor. Kind of brought a little more energy there for a while for Bradley.
It gave him some life, but they got a big hole to dig out of. They've really struggled to get the ball movement. You mentioned the turnover issues they've had, and you've had Loyola able to get out in transition and source some baskets. If you're Bradley in the second half here, Brad, what you have to do is really try to work on execution, and Child's got to get some touches closer to the basket.
The Ramblers playing at an elite level the last couple weeks here in Missouri Valley Conference action, and we have more coming up here as we are only at the half. We'll be back.
He's finally asleep.
Sometimes you need to take a moment for yourself. Instacart is here to help take grocery shopping off your plate. Choose which store to shop from, what items you need, and a shopper will safely deliver them contact-free in as fast as 2 hours. So while you recharge, your kitchen gets safely restocked. Go to Instacart.com or download the app to get free delivery on your first order using the code ORDERTODAY.
This is star power from the jump.
This is the best of the bad goodies this year.
Hello.
Hey, Dad. Bobby's wondering if you could watch cartoons with him.
Yeah, it sounds nice. I hope we can soon.
Dad, check your email.
Okay, click. What is this?
It's Sling Watch Party. You can invite people to watch live TV with you.
Wow.
Hey, family.
Uncle! How'd you get in there, Todd?
Sling Watch Party is live TV together from anywhere, only from Sling. Get the best of cable for the best price.
Hey, Peyton. What brings you to the Coliseum?
I'm here for Super Bowl I. The jetpacks. Are those still around?
Hi, Peyton.
Mr. President.
I understand you want the forward pass tour.
You can't shoot with that.
Omaha.
That's it.
Yes! It's a quarter mile long.
And I don't really want to run any more than I have to.
To infinity and beyond. It's a UFM, an unidentified flying Manning.
Welcome back to our halftime report, a presentation of State Farm Insurance. When you want the real deal, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. It's time for today's profile made possible by the Drury Plaza Hotel at the Arch. NBC correspondent Austin Hansen takes a look at Ramblers senior guard Tate Hall. Timeline, Tate Hall sees Park. Tate Hall drives the lane, lays it in, and one.
He has come to play, Jeff. Tate is really taking it into another gear.
I'm Tate Hall. I'm from Greenfield, Indiana, and my major is finance.
Why Loyola? Definitely, Chicago is one of the best cities in the country. Of course, it's got a lot of diversity, a lot of fun things to do. And obviously, the school here is great. You know, we have a lot of good culture here. You know, with the students and the team all around. So I think it's just perfect fit for me. When I first got here, I had a lot of work to do. As far as growth and, just kind of adapting to the Division I game, for me, I had to redshirt a year, sit out a year. So I think that year really helped me as far as development and being able to adjust, to the speed of the game. Everyone's bigger, faster, stronger. So I think that year off really helped me as far as development. Every day is a new challenge, just kind of seeing different things and, as far as what's going on and, just kind of trying to try to adapt to the changes that have been implemented. So, just kind of taking it day by day and just kind of, adjusting. coach is really on me about being more vocal and, you know, just kind of leading with my voice and being able to hold guys accountable. You know, for me, I've always been someone who's led by example, you know, just kind of let my play, my work ethic show, you know, just kind of way we do things. But, you know, as far as being more vocal and using my voice, I think it's something this year that I can really implement. You know, we talk a lot about the team chemistry. I think that's really important in basketball. You know, being able to kind of have that camaraderie and, you know, just kind of have that togetherness and chemistry, like I said, is really important, you know, as far as being able to do what we want to do. So,
today's profile is made possible by the Drury Plaza Hotel at the Arch, which reminds you to travel happy. More coming up here at halftime as Loyola trying to get one on the road, Bradley trying to protect their home floor.
Go a day without washing your hands, but what about your nose? It's the body's air filter to help protect you from dangerous germs. Now you can clean your nose every day with easy-to-use Navage. Navage uses powered suction to flush out germs, mucus, and allergens, and it relieves congestion naturally without drugs.
I used to get so congested, but Navage cleans out all the stuff that makes me miserable so I can breathe again.
Online and at these fine stores, over 1 million sold. Navage. Clean nose, healthy life.
This is the NBA's marquee matchup. Two franchises littered with Hall of Fame players. Two most successful franchises in NBA history. He's unstoppable. The emerging stars of the NBA.
It's Saturday prime time. It's NBA on ESPN time. Lakers Celtics, Saturday on ABC.
Hi, Peyton.
Mr. President.
I understand you want to forward pass to it.
It's target practice.
Here we go.
Yes! To infinity and beyond.
It's a UFM, an unidentified flying Manning.
Welcome back to our halftime report, a presentation of State Farm Insurance. When you want the real deal, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Let's take a look at our first half stats as Loyola has a 24-point lead here at halftime. And Kevin, they started strong and they just continued to be strong. You see the disparity, a lot of it in favor of the Ramblers.
Well, 59% from the field. This is one of the best defenses in the country, the Bradley Braves. They're getting shredded by the Ramblers right now. And turnovers, Bradley's with 11. This a Rambler team with active hands have kicked the ball loose. They were able to get out points off turnovers. Also big for Loyola. But look at points in the paint. 30-6. The Rambler have got it inside early and often.
Loyola getting some easy twos, and they have a 24-point lead at halftime. Second half starts right after this.
It was never about the gold. It was always about the goals. I didn't reach him just by training my body, but my mind as well. So close your eyes. Visualize all the ways you could break through. Then imagine everything that could go wrong. A false start, a bad turn, broken goggles. Now picture yourself staying calm and overcoming every obstacle. Open your eyes. Train what's under the armor.
Hulu. Damn, that was dope. But it's Hulu doesn't just have live sports.
I don't know, man.
We can make that work, right?
Hulu doesn't just have live sports, it's a lifestyle.
This is the NBA's marquee matchup. Two franchises littered with Hall of Fame players. Two most successful franchises in NBA history. The emerging stars in the NBA.
It's Saturday prime time. It's NBA on ESPN time. Lakers Celtics, Saturday on ABC.
Hey, Peyton, what brings you to the Coliseum?
I'm here for Super Bowl I. The jetpacks. Are those still around?
Hi, Peyton.
Mr. President.
I understand you want the forward pass tour.
You can't shoot with that.
Omaha. That's it.
Yes!
It's a quarter mile long.
And I don't really want to run anymore than I have to.
To infinity and beyond. It's a UFM, an unidentified flying manning.
The Missouri Valley Game of the Week is brought to you by State Farm. When you want the real deal, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. By Zervita. By Prairie Farms, locally owned, locally produced since 1938. And by Mercy, your life is our life's work. Loyola, a 24-point advantage as we begin the second half. Can the Bradley Braves flip the script on the Ramblers? They are playing some of the best basketball that we've seen these Ramblers play in a long time. I mean, they are lights out on both ends of the floor, Kevin.
It's been paint by the numbers on offense for the Ramblers, and they've made it look very easy. Terry Nolan has not scored for the Braves. They need to get him involved in the offense. Big time score.
Don't even have a player in double figures yet. It's been a balanced attack for Loyola. Childs, first fire of the second half off the iron. Williamson with the rebound. That's his sixth.
And Childs has struggled from the perimeter. He is 3 of 9 in this game.
Clemens hit a couple of threes early in the first half. Backs this one out. Clemens with 8 points at halftime. Uguak with 6. Norris fires the 3.
A good defensive stand by Bradley. Loyola probed and probed, but got into a shot clock situation. I'll see if they can capitalize.
Baskin knocked those in from outside. That one in and out.
Well, the Braves have so many balls just skip in and out. You know what they're missing today, too? We talked about earlier. Deshaun Henry is a big basket getter for the Braves, out with that concussion.
You've got Henry out. You also have Ari Boya out. And you think about having a 7-foot-1-inch guy to go against somebody like Krutwig.
Well, the more you lean on Krutwig, the more he likes it. When he feels the defender, does that spin move, comes back over his right shoulder with his strong left hand. Tough cover. You bang on him, he'll find you and feel and then finish. The one wart, though, in Krutwig's game has been at the free throw line. Just an average, at best, free throw shooter.
There you see Henry and Boya on the bench for Bradley in street clothes. You also have Kevin McAdoo taking a leave from the team for family reasons.
So Bradley has to rely on some freshmen. Brian Worley gets some experience.
There's Nolan with a steal. Races to the opposite end, gets the layup to go. Terry Nolan's on the scoreboard for the first time.
He is their big bucket getter, but he has not got open looks. Some of it's because Lucas Williamson has locked him up. They've also had Clemens on him.
Uguak left open, and the three-pointer falls.
Well, Uguak's one of those guys, though. He struggled in past seasons to shoot the threes. 6 of 9 in threes in league play. You have to go out and guard him now. Uguak, an elite defender, has become a complete player with his offensive game.
There's East getting into the lane, gets that one to fall. He was just 2 of 8 in that first half, Kevin. He had some of those 7-8 footers that wouldn't fall in the first half.
Well, that's his game. He's long, he's 6'3". He can get into the paint and finish over the top. Soft left-hander.
Clemens wants to fire a three. That's off the mark. Childs with a rebound.
Crutwork's defense on Childs has been outstanding.
East shoots over top of Crutwig, who sagged off him, didn't want East to scoot around him, and East just shot it right over. Back-to-back baskets now for Sean East.
Well, East is the guy who replaced Dell Brown in this lineup. Brown, a four-year starter, but East great at mid-range.
Crutwig. Wow. Kept the handle, able to finish.
He's just overpowering the Bradley players.
East layup is no good.
Crutwig with 13 to go along with three assists.
There's a foul right in front of the Loyola bench. You see things getting a little bit tougher on Loyola's offensive end. Bradley again 29th in scoring defense and 5th field goal percentage defense.
Well, Crutwig sets a ball screen and he gets an up screen. And here he is with great hands at the other end that disrupt Sean East going to the basket. Crutwig's a guy, he's got soft hands, what I call vice grip hands. You very rarely see him lose a ball that he gains on a rebound or picks up off the deck. And now you bring in Welch. Crutwig takes a breather.
Welch and Tate Hall in for Loyola. Kingsby back onto the floor for the Bradley Braves. Shot clock at 5. There's a tip pass steal by Mast.
That's what we're used to seeing from Bradley's defense. Quick hands. They've not been able to knock very many loose. Can they capitalize?
East dumps it off. Mast hangs, able to finish.
Well, East is getting penetration here in the second half. He's making things happen for the Braves. Off the bounce, that time an assist. A couple other times he got in the lane and scored over the top. Well, you look at the scoreboard, they're still down 23, although they're playing much better here in the second half for the Braves.
Uguat looking for Welch inside, and that brings us to a timeout. The Bradley Braves playing with a better fire here this second half. Trying to get some things rolling. Mast with a two close to the rim. It's still the Ramblers up big.
The emerging stars of the NBA.
It's NBA on ESPN time. Lakers Celtics on ABC.
It is the signature game of the SEC Big 12 Challenge.
Are you serious, America?
This is not a final exam. This is a midterm. Texas is for real.
Let's just find out where we are.
However you want to slice it, this has a big field win tonight.
He's unstoppable!
The emerging stars in the NBA.
It's NBA on ESPN time. Lakers Celtics on ABC.
Hulu show my team hit a game winner. Switch. I seen it walk off for a series clincher. Hulu has live sports. Hulu.
Damn, that was dope. But it's Hulu doesn't just have live sports.
Hulu doesn't just have live sports.
You also have to say 65 live channels. Plus Hulu's entire streaming library.
I don't know, man. We can make that work, right? Hulu doesn't just have live sports. It's a lifestyle.
Yeah, keep us gone. That new song. Yeah, right now. So loud. The whole world watching. 50-27. Loyola in control. Bradley trying to find that spark. And you see Custer there on the right side of your screen on staff now with Loyola.
Hey, Wilbur played in Poland for about 6 months, and coaching's in that young man's blood. Clayton Custer, 2018 Larry Bird MVP, the year that they took him to the Final Four.
Cameron Crutwig, a senior on that team.
Yeah, what a great run that was. You remember Custer hit that buzzer beater against Tennessee. Dante Ingram hit a buzzer beater against Miami. And Marcus Towns, a big three against Nevada. They beat Kansas State the next game and punched their ticket to the Final Four for the Ramblers. First time since 1963. Jerry Harkness had that national championship team for Loyola.
That was Crutwig as a freshman, a team high 17 points against Michigan there in that Final Four game. Now a senior on the bench right now, but leading the way. 13 points, 3 rebounds, 3 assists. There's Tavanainen.
Clemens has been all over him. That's a tough shot.
Tavanainen wanted some contact on the arm to be called a foul. Gets the bucket and no more.
Clemens was in his grill. Good finish by Tavanainen.
7 points for Vile. The big three in that first half. Here's Welch inside. Took an extra step as he was off balance when he caught it. Porter unhappy with that.
We got a do-over in the inbound.
We got a false start. We got laundry on the basketball court.
I've had this happen to me. Was there something out there?
No, there wasn't. No,
I've had this happen to me in Hawaii where they do a do-over. I'm not sure, Porter. If the jacket was going to be on the second half, this is about the point it would have came off. And we had that Twitter account, Porter Mosier's jacket. Can that account still going there, Brad? Because they did not wear jackets this year.
I believe it is. It's in spirit, but it is. There's just no updates on when the jacket comes off.
Well, we used to have the over-under on the time of the clock when it was going to come off. And here's Childs, 1-on-1 now. He's a shot maker.
He's the guy that can get the jacket off in a hurry if he gets going. But he has struggled here today as Childs 3-for-10 shooting in this game. Norris misses. Ubwak to finish and an and-one. Ubwak will head to the free throw line. And we remind you the 2021 State Farm Missouri Valley Conference Men's Basketball Championship returns to Enterprise Center March 4th through the 7th in downtown St. Louis. Local seating capacity restrictions will apply for this year's event. For more information, be sure to download the Arch Madness app or visit archmadness.com for more details.
Well, Ugok has been sensational in this game. He's got 13 points, a number of rebounds. Bass with a bucket there for Bradley.
Bass with his second. He's got 4 points.
It's his constant ball movement by Loyola.
All threes off the mark.
Back in transition. Bradley's got very little in the open court. It's been single coverage on Childs, either Crutwig and now Welch on Childs. You're not being able to shake loose.
He's tried to slide it inside to Mass, knocked away by Ugwak.
Well, they're using that ball screen with Mass and East here in the second half because with Rick Mass, you can roll into the basket, big body, soft hands, or you can use the pick and pop because you can shoot the three ball.
Williamson in for Clemens. Crutwig comes in for Welch. He's working off the Childs screen, skips it back to Mass. Now inside to Childs. Does not get the shot off before the shot clock, as that Loyola defense, Kevin, they are locked in today.
It has been stifling. Active hands, their body position.
the ability to guard on the ball. You see very few straight line drives given up by the Ramblers. They've got all eyeballs looking at the basketball. You've got to really move the backside of the defense around when you play Loyola. And there's a good look at our last seven meetings, Brad.
This one bucks the trend here, Kevin. At five, the last five games have been decided by 8 points or fewer. Three of those five determined by just a point or two. Largest margin of victory the entire series is the Loyola 21-point win. Kevin, 1929. That was a long time ago.
That's when the stock market was rolling right before the crash.
That's Childs.
The last pandemic, the Spanish flu was gone.
It's Childs with the three. As Bradley within 20 now here in this second half. Loyola still rolling. Childs trying to get it going.
T-Mobile knows the new year brings big news. That's why we're bringing out our best deal on the new iPhone 12 with 5G. Right now, get the iPhone 12 on us on every single plan. Switch now and save 20% on your bill versus the other guys. And that's not an introductory rate. That's the best value in wireless. That's right, the iPhone 12 on us on America's 5G leader in coverage. And save 20% per month. Share big moments and big savings at T-Mobile.
This is the NBA's marquee matchup. Two franchises littered with Hall of Fame players. Two most successful franchises in NBA history. He's unstoppable. The emerging stars in the NBA.
It's Saturday prime time. It's NBA on ESPN time. Lakers Celtics, Saturday on ABC.
'52-'34, Loyola in front of Bradley as the Braves trying to pull a little closer there, winning the second half by 6 points and need a few more to catch up to the Ramblers. Well, today's Missouri Valley Conference scores are a presentation of Grinnell Mutual Insurance. Trust in tomorrow. Talk to a Grinnell Mutual agent today as the rest of the league playing. Got Valpo at Illinois State today, and then the rest on Monday.
Yeah, big game. Southern Illinois goes to Indiana State. Tyreek Key, Jake LaRavia takes on Marcus Damask and Lance Jones of Southern Illinois. And then a big one Tuesday. Drake travels to Missouri State.
Crutwig's shot does not fall. Bradley, the opportunity just to slowly chip away at this Ramblers lead. Kevin, if you were on the Bradley bench, what would be a benchmark you would try and challenge your players to go get?
Well, you're 18 down now. It's your whole under 10. If you get this to single digits, you'd feel really good about it. This Loyola team, though, on defense has been outstanding. But we've seen more life here in the second half from the Braves. Sean East all the way to the rim.
Uncontested. It's the easy two, makes it a 16-point game.
East has been a big sparker in the second half as he has got penetration off ball screens.
And when you score the basketball, Brad, a little more hop in your step at the defensive end.
Here's Hall trying to get by Mast, and Mast raises his hand, commits the foul. As Bradley, you just kind of take him however you can get him here, Kevin.
Well, Sean East, there's a screen by Childs. He's able to go right through the middle of the Loyola defense. That did not happen in the first half, but Sean East is showing his ability to penetrate as Bradley's trying to make a run here. They're down 16, chipping in this league by Loyola. Braves trying to keep it going.
It's NBA on ESPN time. Lakers Celtics on ABC.
Hi, Peyton.
Mr. President.
I understand you want the forward pass to it.
It's target practice. Here we go.
Yes! To infinity and beyond. It's a UFM, an unidentified flying Manning.
One app, one tap, that's that. One swipe, one slide, sing it back. One app running with elite QBs. Russell got the cannon throwing clutch TDs. Little cross is an overstep behind the line. Ain't no need to watch the clock, cause you know it's dang time. Yeah.
You know what?
One app with the 30 for 30s. Two finger push ups, Bruce Lee showing no mercy. Fat Five got the crew on deck. Best believe Bo knows OG Dupre. Yeah. One app lets you follow any team, any league, any player. You control the whole scene. Plug in, got the stories on scroll. Shut the dish and not the news like it's food for the soul, yeah. One app, Van Pelt with the facts. One big thing, dropping knowledge in your labs. Always on the pulse, yeah, we got it going on.
Listen up and take cover, here comes a Woj bomb.
One app, college game day attire. Coach O on the sidelines screaming, go Tigers. Throw down when Nina's got that knockout right. There's only one champ at the end of the fight.
She's the goat.
No one else goes deeper, that's a fact. One slide, one tap, it's the ESPN app.
It's a fact.
Love how adrenaline tastes.
That go-go bounce. Can't keep us down. That new sound. Yeah, right now. So loud. Got a little world watching.
Emerging stars in the NBA.
It's NBA on ESPN time. Lakers Celtics on ABC.
.52-36 is our score. Bradley trying to chip into that Loyola Rambler lead as Bradley looking for win number 10 and the Ramblers looking to keep their winning streak going. Well, today's State Farm NBC Scholar Athlete of the Game is Bradley's Jashaun Henry, the junior forward from Saskatoon, Saskatchewan. Averages 11 points, 4.5 rebounds per game. Henry has a 3.40 cumulative grade point average in family and consumer sciences. When you want the real deal, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Kevin, with Henry being on the bench, still out with his concussion protocol, that changes things. They've got a few players on the bench unavailable.
Well, big time with Jashaun Henry. In my book, he is sixth man of the year. 11.2 leads all bench players in the Valley in scoring. And he is the best athlete on this Bradley team. Sorely missed today, along with Ollie Boyer, who's out, and Kevin McAdoo.
Leads the team, too, with a 59% field goal shooting percentage.
He's averaging 1.8 points per field goal attempt. That's unheard of in college basketball. Big opportunity now for the Braves. Got the turnover. See if they can cut into this lead.
Loyola's turnover is now up to 11. Took care of the basketball that first half. Here's Kingsby. Gets the jumper to go.
Oh, big basket. Here come the Braves. They got it down to 14. Can they make a stop?
The start of the broadcast, Kevin, we were talking about Bradley going for win number 10. They'd be in the title hunt at the end of the season as Loyola, 11 wins. They've been rolling here, 6-1 in Valley play. And you figure this is one of those top matchups. And what an impressive first half for Loyola, but you're right, Bradley hanging in there.
Oh, that was an impressive move there by Crowley. Spin move, tough finish.
Have a 9-inch threes off the mark and East rebounds. It gets fouled. I think a foul's called here on Marquise Kennedy.
Rashawn East has been everywhere here in the second half for the Braves. The transfer from UMass had a great freshman year for UMass, where he was one of tops of the nation in assist to turnover. He's been the leader here in the second half of this comeback by the Braves.
He has 10 points, leads the Braves. He had four at halftime. He's been getting deep in the lane and creating for the Braves. Here's Tom Adine, somebody I'd like to get rolling offensively. And a layup. And the foul.
Well, Bradley's already scored more points here in the second half than they did in the entire first half. They've got their offense clicking. Tom Adine. Little hesitation, scoops it up under the defender. Now a chance to go to the line. Good finish. Avile, and we told you, he's the key to the success for Bradley. When he gets 10 points or more, the Braves are undefeated. Tavanainen, he's got 9. Now he's got 10. Count that free throw. Now some three-quarter court pressure by the Braves.
Playing with a lot more fire here. Feeling like they've got an opportunity to make a run. How does Loyola respond?
The last trip they got in the hands of the big man, Crutley. Side to side ball movement.
Williams, the three, is blocked by Kingsby.
Great recovery by Kingsby.
Inside to Childs. Childs wants to go one-on-one on Ugwuok. Shoots it with the right hand, gets it to go.
Great patience by Childs. The double team came, kept his composure and left, and he went one-on-one, and what a finish. We said he makes tough twos. That was a tough two with his weak hand. The left-hander finishes with his right. Now they got it down to 11. Another defensive stop by the Braves. No double, the big man.
Krutwig's going up against Linky. Goes to his left hand and draws the foul and hits his head as he falls. Holding the back of his head right now.
And Krutwig down harder, man. I can't tell if he got hit by an elbow when he went the under move or he hit his head when he came down on the court. We'll get a good replay. Our cameramen have been outstanding during this game. Porter Moore's going to come out on the court, take a look.
Yeah, he's slow. Still laying on his back here.
He got hit in the face as he goes down. And I'm not
he
sure.
He grabbed the back of his head.
He may have hit the court as he went down hard. And there's the trainer attending to Cameron Krutwig.
Let's take another watch and listen as we play it back here in real time.
Yeah, he went down, caught the back of his head on the court.
Couldn't see it, but yeah,
I tell you, this is a tough kid. He's going to stay in the lineup. You see the official, Jeff Malham, waiting to see if he's okay to go. Oh, now he's got to go off.
Tate Hall check in for Krutwig, and he'll check out. And
a tough kid. There's a tough kid
with
right
the trainer there.
There,
yeah. The mustache is coming in there pretty good, isn't it, Kevin?
He need a little more hair in the back of his head to help on that fall. Now you got the trainer looking at his right elbow. Krut, big Bears fan. Likes his music. I kind of like identify with Krut because the mustache. I have struggled growing a mustache also, but he loves the music from the 60s and 70s.
How many more years till his mustache looks like Ditka's? That's the question.
That's us!
There's Link, he lost it off his hands. Loyola gets the turnover. This Cameron Crutwig. He's been, he does so much, Kevin, for the Ramblers here.
Oh, he mentioned that he joined that elite club of over 1,500 points, 800 rebounds, and 300 assists. He is the only center on that list, and there's been 13 players in the last 10 years that have joined that list. He is the only center on it. Tell me what great passing abilities Krellig has. And when you're in this conversation with guys named Larry Bird, Percy Hawkins, Oscar Robinson, he'll go down as the greatest basketball player in Loyola history. Cameron Crutwig.
Top of 9 in. That 3 is off to Mark Ugwak with the rebound. Hall's basket gives him 8 points, the Ramblers' last trip down.
And 2 empty possessions by Bradley at the offensive end.
Jeff Ball is called possession arrow. We'll keep it with the Ramblers. As Darius Hanna, freshman, checks into the game for Connor Linke. As Rink Mast has 4 personal fouls, Terry Nolan has 4 personal fouls for Bradley.
And that's big, Brad, because what you've got that short bench with the injuries to Henry and Ari Boya and the absence of McAdoo, this is a very short, young bench that Brian Worrell's working with. Now he's dealing with foul issues with Nolan and Mast.
So Antonio Thomas comes into the game. Knocked out of bounds there by East.
And you're playing against a Loyola team which is experienced, all 5 starters back from last year's squad. They're the second oldest team in the Valley, just behind Drake. You know, Drake's team is older than the Chicago Bulls starting 5.
It's Welch inside.
He is so quick off the court. Picked up that loose ball. Welch finishes before the defense can even respond. I love his game.
There's a timeout taken by Brian Wardle and the Bradley Braves. That'll be our commercial break cue as the Braves had it down to 15. Can they claw back any closer? 8 more minutes to play here in Peoria.
Gotta keep it moving.
If you do what feels right, then own your style. Phillips One Blade, your style made simple. There's always a way to make life better. Phillips.
Hi, Peyton.
Mr. President.
I understand you want to forward fast to it.
It's target practice. Here we go.
Yes! To infinity and beyond. It's a UFM, an unidentified flying Manning.
One app, one tap, that's that. One swipe, one slide, sing it back. One app running with elite QBs. Russell got the cannon throwing clutch TDs. Little crossing over, step behind the line. Ain't no need to watch the clock, cause you know it's dang time. Yeah.
You know what?
One app with the 30 for 30s. 2 finger push-ups, Bruce Lee showing no mercy. Fat 5 got the crew on deck. Best believe Bo knows OG Dupree. Yeah. One app lets you follow any team, any league, any player. You control the whole scene. Plug in, got the stories on scroll. Shut the dish and not the news like it's food for the soul, yeah. One app, Van Pelt with the facts. One big thing, dropping knowledge in your labs. Always on the pulse, yeah, we got it going on.
Listen up and take cover, here comes a Woj bomb.
One app, college game day attire. Coach O on the sidelines screaming, go Tigers. Throw down when Nina's got that knockout right. There's only one champ at the end of the fight.
She's the goat.
No one else goes deeper, that's a fact. One slide, one tap, it's the ESPN app.
It's a fact. The Loyola Ramblers by 17, currently on a 6-0 run, but the Bradley Braves not going away at all as they had a run here in the second half. Brings it fairly close. Well, our next NBC TV network production, a presentation of Live by Low St. Louis, will be Tuesday, January 26th, as the Missouri State Bears play host to the Drake Bulldogs, finally back in action. Coverage begins at 7 p.m. If you want to experience laid-back luxury in the heart of downtown St. Louis, adjacent to Ballpark Village, slip it. Visit livebylowshotels.com/livebylowsst.louis, Missouri to book your hotel room today.
Big game coming up Tuesday, Brad. Drake, Roman Penn, Tank Hemphill go to Missouri State after that long layoff against Isaiah Mosley and Gage Prim. Two of the biggest scores in the Valley. Dana Ford's got those boys playing well down in Springfield. And Darren DeVries, let's see if they can pick up where they left off. This is the Drake team, undefeated, getting votes for the top 25, but it's been a long layoff for the Bulldogs.
13-0 on the season, and by Tuesday, it'll be 22 days off. Welch misses the shot next to the rim. Childs missed the close-range shot last time down. This time, bucket and a foul. Childs scores it through contact.
Well, this is a great move at the beginning. This is that old school rocker step. Watch him blow. Welch gets him off balance. Welch leaves a little laundry on the court on that move. Childs unable to finish against the second defender.
Ugwak whistled for his second personal foul.
Well, Bradley
and Cameron Crutwig checks back into the game for the Ramblers.
Bradley got this down to 11 a few minutes ago. They have been more efficient here in the second half, shooting 63% from the field for the Braves. Now they got to make a stop.
Tough part for Bradley as Loyola is still shooting 50% themselves here in this second half after shooting better than 50% in the first half. Clemens gets blocked. Now Crutwig gets blocked. Physical inside and now a foul underneath on the rebound.
Ugwak has been sensational in this game. He does all the quiet things for you. Picked up that loose ball, got it off to Crutwig. And Loyola gets possession now. And we talked about Porter Moser. He likes to win. He calls the small battles. This is one of them right here. Can he score in his OB underplays? One of the things that they chart at Loyola.
It's a 14-point lead right now. Bradley had it down to 11. Oh, the bucket in an and one.
All slicing and dicing. The first half, we saw him go with the left hand. This time, he's able to split the defense. You see that skip pass spreads out the defense, and Hall puts it on the deck and gets all the way to the rim before he gets the contact.
The foul is called on Terry Nolan, and that is his fifth personal foul. So Terry Nolan Jr. is done for the day for Bradley. 2 points.
He came in averaging 12. Nolan was their big bucket getter, great three-point shooter. And now Ryan will have to go deeper into his young bench.
Mast with the basketball. He's playing with four fouls. Tavanine in the back cut. Easy lay-in for Vile Tavanine, and he's got 12.
A set play. Take advantage of the overplay in that left wing. And great delivery by the big man Mast. Boy, I like his game. That big freshman is going to be good. Knock in threes. Can pass the rock.
Tip pass by East, and Loyola will inbounds it with 9 seconds on the shot clock.
Now, we haven't talked about Brandon Norris, but he orchestrates his entire offense for Loyola. Porter Moser calls him a pit bull. There's extreme trust in that young man.
Hall fires a tough two. Rebound tipped around by Crutwig, but Childs corrals it. Tavanainen really wanted that three-point shot, traveled with the basketball.
He knew it immediately. Didn't even look at Kip Kissinger, who made the travel call. Tavanainen with his missed opportunity for the Braves. See if they make another stop. And Norris just runs this offense to perfection for Porter Moser.
all over to Ugwuok. Lost it out of bounds. Now here, Ugwuok, Kevin, he's having a good game. 13 points, 8 rebounds. Tell you what, close to a double-double in his only other career double-double. 11 points, 11 rebounds against these Bradley Braves. That was last season.
Ugwuok, elite defender, but this year his offensive game has come on strong, makes this Loyola team even more dangerous. They're trying to get that pick and pop on Mass, but good recovery by Clemens.
Kingsby had a look from three, but it's going to earn a trip to the free throw line. And there's the foul called on Clemens, and that's number three on Keith Clemens.
For the second half, we've seen much better ball movement from Bradley. They've gone side to side. They've used Rink Mass as a high post passer. You have to come out and guard him because his ability to shoot the three ball. And that's allowed Bradley to get some dribble penetration on the reversal. You really have to move the weak side of Loyola's defense. Bradley's done that here in the second half.
Kennedy and Williamson check back in for Loyola. And out of bounds before the timeout is called. And it's going to be Bradley basketball.
That's a big opportunity for the Braves. They can convert on this play.
Ugwuok slow to get up. Something happened on the opposite side of that basketball hoop as he was trying to call timeout, save it from going out of bounds. See him holding the left side of his face. And asking to come out. So Hall's going to come back in.
Ugwuok, we mentioned about how much his game has expanded. Had a big game against North Texas. 26 points, 7 rebounds for the Canadian out of Edmonton.
Close to his season high, 15 points. He scored against Valpo, 26 against North Texas. The ball got him right there.
Got it right in the chiclets. Loose ball. Well, I wonder if they're checking to see if this shot clock could reset.
Well, it's coming off a free throw. It's going to be
okay.
Bradley ball, but reset it to 20 after it touches iron.
See if Brian Rose has another good look at Ugwuok. He took it right in the noggin on that loose basketball.
East has been the answer for Bradley a lot in this second half.
He's been really good with his penetration. Now Chow's starting to take over.
His feet slid as he planted his feet, but a foul called on Krutwig.
I like what Childs did there. Before, he's kind of catched the ball with Krutwig and sized it up. That time, it's a quick sweep move as Krutwig recovered. Childs puts it on the deck, able to get an edge and a step, cause the contact, and now at the free throw line. This is big for Bradley. Can you score buckets? Can you get points with the shot with the clock stopped? Also allow you to set your press. You can make free throws.
Childs gets the first. Hannah checks back in for Bradley. Clemens back on the floor for the Ramblers.
Now, Clemens gives the Ramblers 2 point guards along with Norris if they're going to have to fight through some pressure. Here's the pressure.
Norris draws the double team.
Indiana State, they pressed Loyola that first game down there, and the Ramblers really struggled with it. That time able to fight through it.
Inside to Krutwig, able to finish, kept that ball up high.
What a delivery by Marquise Kennedy. He literally threaded the needle. Now they're going to double Childs.
He's showing it. It looks like they're going to come off him. He tries to flip it inside the hand on it. It's tipped away.
Yeah, bad decision by Childs. He should have backed that out. Let the double go away and reset. Tried to force the action where there was none.
Norris drives, flips to Kennedy, hangs and finishes through the contact of Kingsby.
Norris is so good with his ball in the hand. There's that ball movement and the great feed by Kennedy. The catch and finish by King Krut. Watch Norris. Hesitation knows exactly where Marquise Kennedy is coming from. The delivery and the finish. Now, the three-point play by Marquise Kennedy.
Kennedy with 8 points, four of them at the free throw line. Won the season, 88% free throw shooter, and he cannot complete the three-point play.
That's a rare miss. He's only missed two free throws this season. Williamson on East, trying to stop that dribble penetration.
Kingsby spins away from Clemens. Tough shot in the lane, cannot get the bounce.
Good defensive stand. Every time Bradley makes that run, Loyola gathers their defense, team defense, and makes a stop.
A couple empty possessions for Bradley on the opposite end. Meanwhile, Loyola's made three of their last four shots, making it tough, and Kennedy stepped on the end line, out of bounds. It'll be Bradley basketball when we come back. Loyola, a 16-point lead. Bradley doing all they can to try and come back. Make this one a photo finish.
It was never about the gold. It was always about the goals. I didn't reach them just by training my body, but my mind as well. So close your eyes. Visualize all the ways you could break through. Then, imagine everything that could go wrong. A false start, a bad turn, broken goggles. Now picture yourself staying calm and overcoming every obstacle. Open your eyes. Train what's under the armor.
Hulu has live sports. Hulu.
Damn, that was dope. But it's Hulu doesn't just have live sports.
I don't know, man. We can make that work, right? Hulu doesn't just have live sports, it's a lifestyle.
57-51, Loyola in front of Bradley's. The Braves just continue to try and get closer and closer. Here's our Players of the Game. A presentation is State Farm. When you want the real deal, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And here, Ugwak, Ville Tavanainen, fun to say. And Kevin, they're having good games today.
Ugwak's been sensational. He's 5-7 from the field, highly efficient. He's got those two steals in there. He is the silent assassin for the Ramblers, and Ville Tavanainen, the young man from Finland. Slow start, but it's finished strong as Bradley has made a run here in the second half behind the scoring of Ville Tavanainen.
Ville having quite the interesting off season as once the pandemic started, he went back to Finland, went through his obligatory summer military training for 4 straight weeks. Was not able to go home at all during those 4 weeks. A little bit different than his previous training. Learned how to shoot a gun. No surprise, Kevin, he's a sharpshooter in both the military and on the basketball court.
That is
court.
Not a surprise. That young man can fill it up. You know, last year he shot it in Valley play 46% from distance. He's taking over that spot that Nate Cannell, the great three-point shooter for Bradley last year.
He's 5 of 9 from the floor tonight. He's been getting some twos, and Clemens drug his pivot foot and gives it back to Bradley. 14 turnovers now for Loyola. Bradley had, I think it was 11, Kevin, at halftime, just 5 here in this second half.
Yeah, most of those came early. They got off that slow start, and Porter Mosier will tell you, he likes to keep that turnover around 10. He'll be a little loose with the basketball here, especially in the second half. But they have been outstanding shooting the basketball, the Ramblers. Every year, one of the top offenses in the country in field goal percentage.
It's Thomas missed. Krutwig the rebound.
Thomas made an easy shot into a tough one with that spin move. Krutwig wants a touch.
Tipped by Thomas. They're going to say last touch by Antonio Thomas, the sophomore guard out of Memphis, Tennessee. Played in 33 games a season ago. Started 7 of them. Comes off the bench.
He's got some starting experience with this Bradley team. Is able to go deep in their bench. We've kept talking about those 3 players that are out with injuries. Deshaun Henry with a concussion that happened last Tuesday. He's in protocol. Of course, their big shot blocker in the middle, Ari Boya. Remember the last 2 years, this Bradley team fought injuries and came back and won the Valley Tournament. Plus, they took it to the NCAA.
That's right. Childs was out with a hand injury.
Yeah, 2 years, or last year, yep, 2 years, and then 2 years before that, 2019, they had a number of injuries, got healthy.
I think we got a double technical here as Williamson, as he was falling out of bounds, threw the ball against East.
Neither coach will be happy with this call. As Jerry Pollard goes to the monitor to check this out.
He had a push after the foul, and then here's another
up
look.
Up there, there's a few words spoken. East comes back. A little shove there, and Williamson then, out of frustration, throws the ball at East.
Oh, that's a pretty hard swing at the basketball there.
You see Pollard slaps the technical on Williamson. It looked like then he turned around and threw one back at Sean East. This are two teams that has turned to a great rivalry. Both these coaches have taken these programs, talked about outstanding culture they've developed in these teams. Last year came down to a 1-point game with Childs just missed one at the buzzer to win here, and has literally got a 1-point win here in Peoria.
And Kevin, these two teams, NCAA tournament qualifiers the last 3 years. Bradley didn't get to play a season ago, but representing the Missouri Valley Conference. I asked Brian Wardle when we were talking with him about goals for Missouri Valley Conference regular season title. And he said, we want to get to the NCAA tournament. Like, we want to be healthy when Arch Madness comes rolling around.
He made no bones about that. That was the goal of this team. It's not a regular season title. It's to get in the postseason, going to St. Louis Arch Madness. And he has got the formula for it, Brad. They've done it the last 2 years, 2020, puncher ticket, as they came back from a 3rd seed to win it. And then in 2019, they were a 5th seed and won Arch Madness.
Well, he says a lot goes into winning a regular season title. You have to have a lot of things go your way. You got to stay healthy. But ultimately, you want to get to that NCAA tournament.
You know, this is a year, though, that the Valley can get multiple teams in the tournament. Because if you look at those net scores, you've got Drake with an 11. You've got this Loyola team at the 30 net.
And I told Porter Mosier, he's, you know, he can play a little bit. He's got to go play at Bradley. He's got to play at Missouri State. He's got to play at Drake. And I said, Coach, those are great games to get quad one wins for your program when the NCAA selection committee takes a look at your resume. He wasn't buying what I was selling, though.
So we had both East and Williamson whistled for a technical foul. And Williamson shooting a 1-1 on the initial foul before the two tees. As you see, there's that net ranking.
And this will be a quad two win for Loyola. They get a chance to go to Drake later on and the Missouri State. Both those would fall in the... Drake obviously be a quad one win if they could win there. Of course, she got two opportunities because we're playing back-to-back in the Valley. I'd say great job by Doug Elgin and Jack Watkins because they've had so many disruptions and reschedules. This league is moving right along.
Well, Kevin, it's interesting. To the NBA, they've got teams doing a few back-to-back games with the same team in the same city. In fact, just like Loyola and Bradley play today and tomorrow, the Pacers host the Raptors today and tomorrow. The Hornets are at the Orlando Magic today and tomorrow. So it's different from a college basketball world, but NBA's using it as well.
Taking a page out of the Valley Book, playing back-to-backs as these two teams will go at it again tomorrow. Loyola at Bradley.
You talk about, I mean, there's another opportunity tomorrow for a quality win, right? Bradley, they're winning this second half, 33-24. If they can get a win over Loyola, that's a quad one win for them, right?
Yes, quad win for them, and you'll see their net, if they were able to win that game tomorrow, is going to bounce up big time.
East gets bumped by Norris. And so East to the free throw line. Minute 5 to play. Ramblers up by 15. Bradley got within 11, but just couldn't quite get it to that single digits, Kevin, where the Braves felt like they were going to be able to come all the way back.
They got it to 11, but never had possession with that 11-point deficit to get it to single digits. But you've got to be encouraged by the second half. We saw Brian Worrell send that message early where he took his starters out, put his youngsters in. When the starters came back, a lot more pep in their step. And a good second half here by Bradley. Sean East has led the charge for them here in the second half. And think about this. You've got a Terry Nolan who only scored 2 points. That won't happen tomorrow night. Nolan will come out ready to play.
Bradley's last win in this series with Loyola. A 2-point win in the 2019 Missouri Valley Conference Tournament in the semifinals. They'll get to try again tomorrow as Krutwig still pumped up in this final minute.
Well, we talked about what Norris can do for this team. That was outstanding penetration and delivery to Krutwig inside.
Loyola just able to find a way to win on the road.
Well, Krutwig has quietly put up some huge numbers in this game. 19 points. He's 8-for-10 from the field for King Krut. Great performance. 6 rebounds. He's even got 3 steals on that resume tonight, along with the 3 assists for Cameron Krutwig.
Childs with a bucket. He's got 18. That leads Bradley. But 7-of-16 shooting for Childs, the senior.
And Childs with a slow start, but good second half.
Will is going to be able to dribble this one out. Kevin off to their best start through the first 8 games since 1984-85 when they opened up the Midwestern Collegiate Conference action. 7-1. They went to the Sweet 16 that year. Loyola improves to 12-3. They're 7-1 in Valley play. The Bradley Braves drop to 9-6 and 3-3 in conference action.
Well, the last 4 games since they made that lineup change, bringing Tate Hall off the bench, putting Clemens in, their offense has been extremely efficient. They shoot at 56% today. Only made 3 threes. They didn't need it. Krutwig, another huge game with 19. And Ukwok
with 13 was outstanding.
The Ramblers had a 24-point lead at halftime, and they're able to cruise on to a victory here. Final score, 69-56 over Bradley. Our next NBC game of the week, Tuesday, January 26th, Missouri State plays host to Drake. Our coverage starts at 7. For Kevin Lehman, I'm Brad Wells. Have a good day.